a man of Pencil Lois Lane. Used to weigh my problems when I went insane. Took me from the depths when I lost my name. Ooh, give me something I could live for. Now everyone is wondering what's the change. They don't recognize I have so much to say. And I never thought someone could love someone so much that they'd give up on everything. I know I will be there when you need me. I will be there when you're crying, baby. I will be there when you need someone to tell you that you're beautiful, baby. I will be there when you need someone to run away. I will be there when you need someone to dance with. I'm your lover till the skies turn gray, girl. Cause you're beautiful, baby. It's your beautiful, oh, you're beautiful. It's your beautiful, baby. It's your beautiful, it's your beautiful. It's your beautiful, baby.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. My name is Krishna Offer Varela. Welcome to one more Krishna International Magazine show. Tonight's show is The Power of Beauty. And I have here the Miss Cape Verdean Pageants 2011-2012, Tirza Évora. Hey, Tirza.
Hi.
Beautiful. How are you today?
I'm good, and you?
Thank you so much for coming to my show. It's such a pleasure to have a Miss Cape Verde here represent our country.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you. So how you ended up on this? How was the project? How you participate for the Miss? What you did?
My participation, actually, I never thought in my life that I'm going to win the Miss Cape Verde. I always like to play sports and everything, but my mom always pushing me to be more feminine, you know. So I went to this, first of all, I won the Miss of my high school in Cape Verde.
Great.
So I went to Miss South, it's one of my islands. So I went to Miss Cape Verde, and I was not expecting to win, to be honest with you, but it was a great experience, and I'm always going to represent my country.
Okay, great. But what was that click that inspired you to participate?
I don't really know. It is funny because I was not for that thing. Everybody was telling me, oh, you're good, you're beautiful, you're tall. But I think it was more because of somebody else wanted me to go, not mm-hmm. because I wanted to go. Mm-hmm. So I always did fashion shows in Cape Verde. Actually, when I was 14, I won this modeling thing. I went to participate in another country, but it was just like to have fun. But well, I think it was great.
Great. You are extremely beautiful, special in person.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I really love it. So, but I want to the people know, because today we did The Power of Beauty. Mm-hmm. It's not just because your external beauty. It's because the beauty is the inside, the nature of beauty. And I know you for being relating you to you this last 1 year, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm being liking your inside.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm bringing you here to share with the people, so the people can understand that you won this award not just because you're external, because you are beautiful inside. And I know that on the Missy, normally they make a few questions. What they make any question for you guys, anything that represents you, that make you become unique?
Actually, on the competition, they didn't, but before the competition, they have us like talking to the organization of the Miss Cape Verde, and you have, you know, to spoke a little bit, what's your projects, what you want to do if you want the Miss Cape Verde, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? We always, misses, they always trying to help people, you know. I know that my country is not, have like a lot of people still living in the streets, don't have nothing to eat, and then you have to be a simple person. You have to feel, you know, you have to put on them shoes and to feel the pain and to be a person with an open minded to help people. I think you need to be beautiful, of course, to represent your country, but you also have to be amazing inside to be a person that can help anybody.
This is such a beautiful special coming for a young girl. This is great. It's so inspiring. I know that you won not only those three awards that you said. I know that you've been participating a lot. You want to mention about your awards?
Yes, of course. I won the second most beautiful woman in West Africa.
Actually, I heard that you were the first one. And you give up your award with a beautiful attitude for some girl from Africa.
Usually on the competition, to make you understand what happened, on the competition, they always have like something that they, you know, they try to put on top, just like you asked me about in Cape Verde. But in, it was on Cote d'Ivoire, it was genital mutilation. Okay. So the girl from Guinea-Conakry, we have like almost the same points. I have 15, she got 14 or 13, I don't really remember. The organization came to me, talking to me, because I was already here in America living. So they told me, what do you think to you to, you know, to help us getting this traditional thing in Cape, in Africa, because I don't have it in my country, in Cape Verde. So my speech, it was all about women's, how our women are special to people, you know what I mean? So it was all about that. So her speech, it was about what she, you know, what happened on, because what happened to her. So I give it to her because I think that she can fight for it in Guinea-Conakry. She can fight for it in Africa because she's already there, and I'm not over there. I'm here, and I'm here for study. I'm not going to be focused to do that. I was already stopped my school for two times to go there, so I don't think it was a good idea. But I felt so good when I did it because she mentioned, actually, she was, you know, telling everybody on the, you know,
she was
just like me, and I was like, you know, she, when the organization spoke to me, I was like, of course, yes, I feel like we need to stop this in Africa.
That one was a really beautiful attitude.
Thank you.
Real. To give up your award, your crown, to someone else because the situation that they were passing.
I think on that situation, it wasn't about the crown, but it was about, like, you know, doing something good to Africa. And then that's what felt, yeah.
Yes. It is what Cape Verde need to concentrate a little bit more, because most of those other African models or miss, or in every world, they got normally well recompensated. How was your award? It's just your crown, and they,
like, you know, Cape Verde is not a big country, so I wasn't expecting that much. But I always represent my country, no matter what. But of course, the girls from West Africa was telling me the, you know, what they have as a gift, and I was just like surprised. But it's okay. I'm a fighter, and I'm an independent woman. I like to fight for my things. I like to feel. In the end on the light, I like to feel like, yes, I got it because I fight for it. Nobody give it to me. So,
but what do you think that is that reason that Cape Verde doesn't do too much for misses or sometimes for an artist?
It's not even the organization, because the organization try everything else. And sometimes the sponsor is not even in Cape Verde. They try something else, because in Cape Verde, you know, we're not big, and then it's not that they don't want to help. It's because they don't have the money to do that. That's why a lot of the things they try to, you know,
on
they
the
try.
you can fix it. Yes.
So they try to help people, another people from another country, or, you know, try to help others. But it's okay. I always love my country, no matter what. I'm a proud Cape Verdean.
That is fantastic. I really enjoy this. So me, I did some modeling too, and I know that you are doing some modeling careers. But before we pass to Marley, because we're about to come take a break so the picture can see some of your Miss picture.
Of course.
I'd love you to, what you can inspire for young Cape Verdean, young girls that would love to become a Miss. How they can do, because you said they were doing some bullying for you when you were like a girl,
When I was a teenager, I used to play soccer and basketball for the school, and I was always, you know, with sneakers on, you know, big shoes, and I don't really, you know, care about the being, you know,
beautiful.
But if you have a dream, you know, don't you never stop dreaming, because it's something that you have to fight for. You have to put your dream here and fight for it. In the end of the line, if you don't have the dream all done, but you fight for it, and that's the good feeling, because you'll be like, oh yes, and you have an answer, and you don't have a question like, I should have did it, you know?
Yeah.
It's better to have an answer, oh, I did it, but you know, it's a good experience. If you have a dream, just go for your dream, no matter what your dream is. You want to be a Fox soccer player, football player, you want to be whatever you want to be in life, you want to be a modern, yes, you're in Cape Verde. I know the Cape Verde is a small country, but I'm here, and I'm here living my life, and I'm here by myself. I don't have a lot of families here. My parents is in Cape Verde, but I'm here fighting for my things. Just be independent. Just let it fly.
It is, guys. This is beautiful. The power of beauty is exactly just like this. It's the nature of beauty inside and outside. And the beauty is when we can relate with the people beauty. It's beauty as well. We're going to take a small break right now. You're watching Krishna International Magazine Show. I have right here watching as my guest, Tirza Evra, the Miss Cape Verde pageant 2012. We're going to take a small break and come back soon. Stay there. Thank you.
Entiende lo que nadie puede entender.
You never see it coming.
Quiero amarte para siempre.
The next thing you know,
enséñame cómo amar incondicionalmente.
Unconditional love. See, I'm looking for no diamonds. Ain't digging for no gold. Just somebody to
Good evening. You are watching Krishna International Magazine Show. I'm Krishna Offer Varela. Today is the power of beauty, and my guest is Tirza Evra, the Miss Cape Verdean pageant. Tirza,